Look, I mean, as comedians, we sometimes like point out the hypocrisy of society or the ridiculousness that we see. And so we're just trying to give lessons and tell the truth using jokes. So I try to point out the Islamophobia. There's academics like Dr. Hatem who do it through books. I do it through jokes. But comedians, sometimes we can get people to listen to us more because we're making them laugh.
Are you concerned as a comedian about Islamophobia, really?
Of course. I mean, it's a real thing. And it happens every day. It even happens to us as comedians, you know. We get a lot of opportunities are not open to us. And sometimes audiences look at us differently. So we have to challenge all of these things. And we just happen to do it with laughter.
As a comedian, have you experienced personally Islamophobia?
I think every Arab or Muslim has experienced Islamophobia. So, I mean, it wouldn't be something special because I'm a comedian. But as comedians, yes. I mean, sometimes people might laugh at jokes in ways that we don't want them to. And sometimes we don't get opportunities that are open to everybody else. So, of course, we experience it.
When you're trying to help people and reduce Islamophobia on the field, in the mindset that is behind, as an American or an Arab?
Well, look, my identity is all of those things at once. I don't think of myself as sometimes as an American, sometimes as an Arab. I'm all of those things all the time. So when I'm doing it as who I am as a person and trying to talk about my real life experiences. So all of those identities are part of who I am all the time.
And you obviously are concerned that Islamophobia hurts America as well, not only Muslims.
Yeah, of course. Islamophobia keeps Arabs and Muslims as constant strangers in America. And if we can use comedy as one of the ways to help solve that problem a little bit, then that's great.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks.